Hello and welcome to the fourth video of Object-Oriented Programming in Roblox. So today we are going to use what we learned about module scripts and metatables and combining these two powerful tools for the optimal experience of object-oriented programming in Roblox Studio. So the reason we can combine these two things is since module scripts are essentially just tables that can be required and like returned by different scripts, you can use metatables along with these module scripts tables to make a really powerful system. So in order to demonstrate, I'm going to go into service scripts service and create a module script. And I'm going to name this module script the base. And just for clarification, I'm going to change the variable base, and whenever you change the main variable of a module script, you also have to change the return statement. So this return module will change to return base. I do this just to make my code a little bit less confusing. So now we have this base class, and since we're going to be using metatables, we first want to assign the index meta method of base to itself. So whenever it is indexed by a child object, the child object won't error the script. It will bring it up to the base. So now what we want to do is, in order to make making metatables and setting the meta methods of the metatables easier, we want to make a basic function called new. And notice how we are using the colon here, so we automatically get the self variable, so we are able to apply this method to child objects. So this is our function, which is new. So since we named this function new, what it's going to do is it is going to create a child object of this base. So we will create this object, or table, you could say. And we're going to, of course, give the set metatable method our two curly brackets to indicate we want to make a new table. And we're going to use self. So the reason we are using self here is because there's a colon here. So you could just use base to set the metatable of whatever new object you want to the base. But if there's a child object that is inheriting from another child object, we want to have self here so it doesn't skip a generation, so to speak. By generation, I mean, like, if there's multiple childs, you want the closest parent to be the one that's the metatable of that child. So also, what we're going to do here is we're going to set the index meta method of this table to itself. So this leaves a lot of confusion when you are making child module scripts. So we automatically set the meta method index. So whenever a child object tries to index something it doesn't have, it automatically sends it to this T, which then sends it to the base if it doesn't have it. And we're going to return this table. So this is a really basic function that is going to help you when you are making child objects. So let's do that right now. So I'm going to make a new module script. We're going to call this module script child1. And we're going to change this variable to child just to make it less confusing. So we have this child module. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a variable for the base module script path. Notice we are not going to require this base just yet. So let's do local base equals script dot parent dot base. So notice how in the base module script, we return T, which is a table that sets the metatable of itself to the base, and its index meta method it set to itself. So we make a table and we return that table. And since this local child is making a table right here, instead of leaving these two curly brackets, we can instead do require the base and then use the function new. So what this is going to do is we have the base here, which is the base class that we just made. And this child module script is going to require this base and create a new child table. Whoops. Make a new child table. And this child table is going to have the index meta method set to itself, and it's going to be a like child meta table of the base, and the base is going to be a meta table of this child. So in order to demonstrate how this is going to work, we're going to make a variable for this base class. We're going to do base.number equals 5, let's say. And also notice how I'm only using periods here, because using other indexing methods within your module script is a lot more cluttered, and this is just a generally good workflow to get used to. And it also looks a lot more similar to other programming languages when they are using object-oriented programming. So we are going to make a new normal script in order to demonstrate this, because also remember that module scripts do not run unless they are called upon by a normal Roblox script. So we are going to require the child, because we don't need to require the base, because the child is already requiring the base, so it'll do that all in the back end. We don't need to worry about that. So local child equals require script.parent.child. So this gets the child module script, and then we can print child.number. So what this should do is it should get the child, and the child creates a new like child class of the base, and since we print the child base, since the base is a meta table of the child, the script should go through and be like, oh, the child table does not have a index called number, but it'll be like, oh, there's a meta table with the index set to itself, as we did right here, and it'll be like, oh, this base has a number which is equal to 5. So if we play this, so that was a slight syntax error. This is a pretty simple error. I just forgot to, instead of just doing script.parent.child, I did it's script.parent.child1. That's just a naming issue. So let's try it again. As you can see, it prints 5. So this system works pretty well, other than the fact that I did not define my path correctly, which you should be able to do quite easily. So the reason it is beneficial to combine meta tables and module scripts is for the idea that you can communicate between your normal scripts and your module scripts without keeping that to one script. Because with normal meta tables, you can only put your meta tables in a single script unless you use like bindable functions or bindable events to send them around. But with module scripts, which on their own, they can't really use inheritance or use object-oriented programming, you can combine meta tables and module scripts to allow your normal scripts to be a lot less cluttered. And so the biggest thing, benefit of using this sort of workflow, is abstraction. So what abstraction is it's basically abstraction. There we go, I can spell it correctly. What abstraction is it's basically just putting away like the things you don't need to know that are unnecessary for you to know at the time to make your scripts simpler. So the way we used abstraction here is all we did is we required the child and we printed the child number. But in the background, this child, it creates a new base, and the base is like the meta table, and this base has a number. We don't need to know any of that. We just need to know that this child has a number variable, even though it may be taking it from the base. So that's an example of abstraction where our functions and our code is kind of like put away, so we don't need to know it at the time, which makes it a lot simpler, especially if you're working in a group of people. People only need to know the base functions. They don't need to know the stuff that goes on in the background, which makes it a lot easier for like bug testing, and it just makes code a lot easier to read, because if you have all of your code encapsulated in these module scripts that are also meta tables, and these module scripts have the functions, and each module script just runs functions and does things like that, your main script can be very simple, and you can always go to where you need to go, wherever you need to go, like whenever you need to go, without much hassle. And editing errors or fixing errors will be a lot easier in that sense. So yeah, that's a basic understanding of combining module scripts and metatables. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed watching this video. In the next video, I will be talking about how you can apply object-oriented programming in Roblox Studio to all of your scripts, regardless if they're module scripts, or local scripts, or normal scripts, how to use this idea of metatables and combining that with the flexibility and integration of module scripts throughout your whole Roblox game. So, hope you enjoyed. Make sure to like and subscribe, and make sure to comment any questions or video ideas in the comments below. I hope you have a good day, and goodbye.